Good morning, Live Oak. Today is Friday, December 13th, 2019. I'm
Savion. I'm Joey. And this is your news from the Nut House. The PSAT 9 test is scheduled for January 19th, 2020. All ninth graders who are interested in taking the PSAT test can sign up and purchase the exam starting on Monday, December 9th in the ASB office. The cost of the test is $20, and the deadline to purchase is January 10th.
Seniors, we're going to Disneyland and California Adventure. To reserve your spot, come by the ASB office to make a $50 deposit. Payments can be made throughout the year. Don't miss out. Fundraisers might be in the works to cut out the cost of $325.
Seniors, if you still need to complete your civics points, opportunities are available. Do you rock at science or math? Do you read the Constitution just for the articles, or maybe just know the Bill of Rights? We are looking for just a few more tutors for the COCO and CRAM. Earn up to 5 civics points and possibly extra credit. Spots are limited. Please see your civics teacher for a recommendation from or Ms. Faulkner in room 102.
Seniors, please stop by the front office at brunch, lunch, before or after school to check the spelling of your name on the diploma. College reps from De Anza, Evergreen, West Valley, San Jose City, and Mission will be on our campus January 9th. Sign up via Navions to attend.
Seniors, you have a chance to win. Have you completed the free application for federal student aid, FAFSA application, or DREAM Act application? If not, please complete it by December 16th to be entered to win prizes. Stop by the counseling office for more assistance. Okay, you know who you are. The time has come and it is the end of the first semester already. All students parking in the student parking lot will be cited if you do not have a parking permit. Make sure your parking permit is visible from your car window and permits are $40 with and $60 without ASB. Please come to the ASB office for a permit application. Thank you.
According to Inc.com, Santa Claus was originated in a newspaper ad.
The Latinx Student Union is meeting at lunch on Monday in room 501. See you there.
On this day in history, in 1946, the UN accepted 6 Manhattan blocks from John D. Rockefeller Jr. I'll tell you what I want, what I really, really want. No, tell me what you want, what you really, really want.
I wanna really, really, really wanna take a second. Well, guys. Apparently next week we're not gonna have any news. But after that, there's Christmas coming about. So today in Travis in Traffic, I'm gonna ask people what they want for Christmas. Let's go. Hi George, let me ask you one question, and that is, what do you want for Christmas?
Alright, I'm looking for a sous vide machine.
Nice. Hey guys, what do you want for Christmas?
Hi, Merry Christmas!
Wait, guess what I want?
Yeah, what do you want?
I know what I want.
Oh yeah?
ASAP Rocky.
Anyone else?
I'll take a new phone.
Thank you guys.
Hi, Travis.
What do you want for Christmas?
Love. That's what I want. What do you want, Nate?
A new dog.
Yeah, where?
Some women.
Alright, thanks guys. Have a nice day. I'm just wondering, what do you want for Christmas? Name me one thing.
Some AirPods Pro. Okay.
A dog? I don't know.
What do I want? I want a new phone.
Oh, I should have said
I also
that.
Want a new phone.
Phones, gang. Thanks, guys. Yeah. Hey, what do you want for Christmas?
For Christmas? Oh, dude, I love some Pokemon booster packs more than anything. Yeah, some Pokemon booster packs.
Nice. I want Pokemon booster
cards. All for dual school.
All for dual school. Hi. What do you want for Christmas, guys? Name me one thing.
I want parents who love me.
I'm okay with what I have.
She's really content with it. Thanks, guys. Man, that's... I do hope she gets parents who love her. Hey, guys, I just want to ask, what do you want for Christmas? Name me one thing.
I want a JBL Flip 5.
Black Air Forces.
Nice. Thanks, guys. All right, quick, guys, what do you want for Christmas?
Ooh, love. Money.
Shout it, guys.
New skirt.
A cute new skirt.
I still don't know.
All right, thanks, guys. What do you want for Christmas? Name me one thing.
I'm sorry, I don't know. Wait.
I want some tech decks, you know? Also, a Jackie Chan cardboard cutout.
Dang. The newest Legos, obviously.
What?
Marvel Legos.
All right, Legos and a Jackie Chan cardboard cutout. Thanks, guys.
You're buying all this stuff, right?
All right, that was really cool to know what people want. Out of all of them, probably the Jackie Chan cardboard cutout was most interesting. And what else? Oh yeah, what I want for Christmas. Guys, I just want all the love you guys give me, all the attention. It's all nice. But reality, probably 144 hertz monitor. I really hate how my computer keeps stopping at 60 frames. All right, guys, bye.
Happy birthday to Sadia A, Fabian C, and Yasmin I. Have a great day, guys.
We will be offering our Cyber High After School program for remediation. The program begins Monday, January 13th, 2020, and runs Mondays through Thursdays from 3:10 to 4:10. This is a computer-based program where students can make up F's for graduation or D's for college eligibility. Students should sign up with his or her counselor as soon as possible.
Good day, Live Oak High School Acorns. I'm Mrs. Calabretta, your principal for this school year. I'm addressing all of you with this video to discuss a few topics and set a positive tone and atmosphere for next semester. Congratulations to all of you at the close of fall semester. All of us are at different points of our education and our lives, but we are nearing the end of this school chapter. With that comes a lot of celebration, relief, and success. But for some, it also comes with much anxiety, concerns, and questions about what comes next. Please know that we as a staff are here for you, no matter where you fall in those emotions, students and teachers alike. I want to start by saying that I am proud to be the principal of Live Oak High School, and I'm proud for the opportunity to have each and every one of you as students and staff. This has been a new experience for me too, and serving as principal comes with lots of ups and downs, but I try to take those as learning opportunities and room to grow. I believe that every student here has the ability to be caring, considerate, determined, and respectful people. We all have moments at which we are not at our finest, and we all make mistakes, myself included. I personally don't judge any of you for that, but it is mine and administration's job to help you along the way and support everyone in the challenges that may face you. Being a student is hard, especially in a day where you're surrounded by social media, drug and vape influence or use, and stigmas from peers and adults that violence, drugs, virtual likes and followers are truly what matters. Each and every one of us come to Live Oak with a different upbringing, different belief system, different values, and different experiences. While it makes it challenging to run a school of over 1,200 different people, it also makes it beautiful and exciting. We have a job to educate and support you in your four-year endeavor of high school and to prepare you for whatever opportunities await you. Your only job, though at times it seems hard, is to learn and accept that support. I next want to address how we can do a better job, both you and I. All of you are aware that there are distractions and poor behaviors that are happening and have been occurring on our campus and numerous other campuses in this area and beyond. The following behaviors have been an increasing problem here at Live Oak and are not tolerated or accepted on our campus. Vaping or any electronic nicotine vape devices. Dabbing, waxing, or any other type of marijuana or THC use. Possession of, selling of, use of, or sharing of any illegal substance, which could include nicotine, marijuana, CBD, THC, alcohol, narcotics, opioids, edibles, and prescription drugs. Additionally, physical confrontations, fights, filming of fights, arrangements of confrontation, or failing to disperse from the area are also problematic. I realize that these behaviors are not acceptable to all of you, and I realize that it should be common knowledge that these are not allowed and against school policy. However, I do owe it to all of you to do a better job in reiterating this message and help you learn and support you in making positive, better choices on campus and in life. With that, I also think we could do a better job at informing and educating everybody on what the consequences for those behaviors are. There's a stigma of sometimes something doesn't happen or that we're not doing enough. Students partaking in any of the previously mentioned behaviors will receive at least 1 to 5 day suspension, depending on the severity or if sales are involved. Expulsion is an option as well. Additionally, the student resource officer, who also works for Morgan Hill PD, serves students with legal citations, which are in lieu of arrest and require a referral to the probation department. Furthermore, we are requiring things such as counseling, substance abuse classes, anger management therapy, and more to support students in making better choices and help them move on when these acts are committed. With a lot of that not being my most favorite part of my job, I feel like it's important that we educate you on that. All of that being said, it is important to recognize that it's not just myself, administration, teachers, parents, or the police department who have a problem with these behaviors and are concerned about it. Several students and your peers come to us on a daily basis because of the impact that it has on everyone. It is reported that students want to use the restroom, just to use the restroom. Students want their classrooms back. Students want to feel safe on campus and don't want violence. Students want to learn. I want you to know that I think of everyone on our campus and in our school community as a partner. Each of you included, I mentioned before that our job is to educate and yours is to learn. When these behaviors occur, they prohibit others from doing their job. I trust that each of you has something positive to contribute to our partnership and challenge you to have a voice. By voice, I don't mean snitching, but rather speaking up and to us on what you need to be successful in any activity you want to partake in. Speak up for your right to feel comfortable. Speak up when someone is making a poor choice. Speak up when you think the staff, myself included, could make an improvement or do something about things differently. Speak up for what you, as young adults, need and want. Each of you deserves the best, deserves opportunity, and deserves a voice. With that, please take the 2-week break to rest, relax, and reflect. What do you want for yourself next semester? What questions do you have? What or who could help? I strongly believe that the students in this school can be amazing and do good things. This school has numerous great activities from band, athletics, FFA, clubs, and more. There are students here who are currently thriving, and I would like to invite all of you to be those students. There are 1,200 students and one of me. Please partner with me to make change. I look forward to a productive, positive, and proactive spring semester. I hope you enjoy your break. Thank you.
And that's all for today, Live Oak. Have a fantastic Friday.